Hello students, how are you? So today I'm going to continue with my same lesson, that is business studies. In that, you see, I'm going to, my lesson name is Components of Business Studies. So already I have started the lesson. I have given the explanation, components of business studies, introduction I have given, economic activities and the types of economic activities. So today my topic is exchange and evolution and growth of commerce. So today these are my topics which I am going to explain you. First, let me know you all about the exchange. Exchange means what? Of goods and services. So the manufacturer, he will manufacture and produce the goods from manufacturer to wholesaler, from wholesaler to shopkeeper, from the shopkeeper to the consumers, that is customers. So let me give. So this distribution of goods and services is called exchange. Exchange is the connecting link between the production and the consumption. So the production, it will produce the goods, and from the producer it should reach to the consumers. That is enough. The one who buy the goods and services. So, in between them, there are links are there, that is wholesaler and the shopkeeper. So, see, the goods produced at a place have to reach to the consumers. So, somewhere it has been manufactured. From the manufactured place, it has to go to the consumer. How it will go to the consumers? The consumers directly, they won't go to the manufacturer to buy the goods. They'll go to the shopkeepers to buy the goods. So, different places, what they will do, they distribute their goods to different places. So during the course of production, the producers take into consideration the market study. In case if they manufacture one good, it will sell in the market or the people will buy or not the products. Transportation, moving the goods from one place to another place. Next, storage of goods. So they need a warehouse to store their goods and goods. So determination. So if they produce a good, how much price they have to cost? What is the price of this good? That is called as a determination of price. Next, advertising. So after manufacturing the good, directly to go to market, they have to first interact the consumers in a very interactive manner, in a very effective manner. So many advertisements for each and every product, we are seeing the advertisement. Through that advertisement, the people are attracted towards the product, they are going and buying. So these are all things the producer has to think for. The first one, that is a market study. The next one, that is an attraction. The next, transportation, storage of goods, determination, how much price cost should be for this good. And the next one, that is an advertisement. When you give an effective advertisement, then only his product will sell in the market. So etc. These are all things he has to take into consideration, has to study. And all these aspects are included in the process of the exchange of the goods. So today, we have money as a medium of exchange. Nowadays technology is so much advanced, that is instead of giving currency, we are transferring the money from bank to bank. Transactions are going on. Earlier debit card, now also debit card, credit cards are there. Now Google Pay, Paytm, Phone Pay, each and every product sim transaction through the mobile, through every. So media is currency, money is there. And the money exchange of goods and services is taking place. So the exchange system has become the foundation of the business. So give and take, buy the products, that is called as an exchange. And the next one, that is an evolution and growth of commerce. Do you know what you mean by commerce? Commerce is nothing but buying and selling the goods, is called as an commerce. So evolution, development, lots of changes we are seeing. So let me explain that. So all the economic activities of human beings is considered as an commerce. That means buying and selling, especially on a large scale. So it includes production. So I already said you, the goods are manufactured, banking, insurance agencies for their products, you know, insurance, advertisement, transportation and other factors which facilitate exchange of goods and services to the consumers. So evolution is a gradual change. A gradual change means what? It's a change step by step, slowly, of activity that takes place over a long period of time. So the evolution that has taken place in commerce is a part of the business which is concerned with the distribution of goods and services. Evolution of commerce has crossed over several stages to achieve today's position. What are the several stages? So there are totally 8 stages are there. So in the next class I'm going to explain you all 8 stages from the early till today, how the currency is being changed. So evolution, lots of changes, developments we have seen in the society as well as in the human life. So this is the thing today. I'll explain you all about the exchange, evolution and growth of commerce. Commerce is nothing but, it's called as in a buying and selling goods, is called as in a commerce. Evolution is for development, lots of changes we have seen. Growth, still it is growing, gradual means step by step. Exchange means what? Goods, exchanging the goods. So there is a link between the production and the consumption. What is the link between production and consumption? That is in a wholesalers and the shopkeepers. So the product, the producer has to keep in his mind what are the things when he manufacture a good, produce a good. He has to study the market, he has to see the transportation, he has to see the storage of goods. Determination means he has to keep a price, cost for that product. And the next one is an advertisement. If when he give an effective advertisement, then only his product will sell in the market. So this is the thing. So in the next class, I'm going to explain you all about the stages, evolutions. So I hope you all